I finally have an idea how and what to paint, and we are doing the background in this white color and the red will be the face, because we are supposed to do something about the Gen Z and about Poland and how we feel in our country and stuff. So I decided to like use our flag colors to paint it. She wanted us to use templates, but I like don't have a idea how to use them, so I'll just paint how I like it to be. And we have this evening to do most of it, and yeah, I have no idea how I'm supposed to finish this in just one day, but yeah, let's do this. I think I will use like this primer, and I also have okay, so I have this is like a gesso, so I never used it and I really want to use it today. She wanted us to use this like square one. It's like 50 centimeters by 50. It is quite big. Look at this, it is like this big. This video is so chaotic, so and just I think I will gesso it, let it dry, and then we can start sketching. Okay, let's just start it and don't waste more time because I won't do this today.
When you want to make your videos cinematic.
What a disaster. I don't know about you, but I have a talent to make everything dirty, so I need to create some type of barrier between my carpet and the paint. So I will create it from this newspaper and I hope it will be enough, because I don't want any paint near my carpet. So I've glued this with tape and I think my carpet won't be damaged. You can see the protection has been already tested, so it already saved the carpet. So now I just have to wait for it to dry and we can start painting. And of course we need to sand this, and I know it was pre-gessoed, but I still wanted to get rid of all the texture. I think it is much better now. After sanding, I think it will be great. Okay, I don't have a sandpaper, so I'm gonna just... So now we can just start with the painting itself. I'm so excited, but then I was extremely tired because it was 11 p.m. already. So yeah, thank you for sticking out with me. And yeah, I started this painting with the sketch with pencil, and I decided to create a portrait which is like emerging from the background, something like this, and I really liked this idea. So I started the sketch, but I wasn't really happy with the size of the head I've made. After walking away from it, I came back and I said, well, it is definitely too small for it. So I needed to start the sketch from the zero once again, which really delayed the outcome, and I lost like half an hour doing this. But yeah, actually the painting part of it went really smoothly and I had a lot of fun doing this, and it was quite easy. I've made a very cringe and very bad photo of myself for this painting, like the reference photos were mine. But I won't show it to you because it is so bad, like, it is so funny, but yeah, it was really needed for the painting. When it comes to the painting process, it was super annoying. From time to time, I needed to dry the entire paint because it was stopping, like, doing what I wanted to do. So it took much more time than you think because of the break time and, like, waiting for the paint to dry. I think I might let it dry for now because right now it is like basic shapes, and then I will add some lightness to, I think, this side. It will look cool, but I will add some more shadows, you know, some gray tones. Quite pleased with how it looks right now. I actually kind of like the like pencil under this paint, and I don't know if I will like it as much if I paint the background white, but we'll see. For now, let it dry because I don't want to mess it up. So yes, half hour and I am back. And actually this is my palette. By the way, this is the mess I created here. This is the painting and this is all of the stuff I am using right now, so yeah. As you can probably tell, the time for more details came, and I am using for shadows a bit of purplish red, if I can call it. I just mix some blue with the red to make this darker burgundy color, and I am loving how it looks actually here. And then I've added some details like the texture of the skin using very little. It is not a brush, but the thing for the nail art, which was a bit destroyed, so I started using it for paintings. And I really enjoy always the effect it gives for the skin. And now we can move to the background, which is very abstract, and I decided to make this like hair effect using the spatula, or however it's called in English. And yeah, I love how the face is emerging from the background, and I am super happy with the result. Yeah, so in this agony I forgot to record the ending, so this is the painting. I am loving how it looks, and yeah, I hope you enjoyed this format, like this type of videos, a little bit more casual. And yeah, I am super happy with the result of this painting, and I will see you in the next video very, very soon. So yeah guys, bye!